What's up guys, in this tutorial, I will show you how to prevent dropped frames and lag while streaming or recording with OBS Studio. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. Your ability to fix dropped frames and lag while streaming or recording with OBS will largely depend on your system specs and your network connection. Open up OBS Studio and navigate to your settings window. In the Video tab, make sure to set the base or canvas resolution option to your native monitor resolution. It should show up for you here, but in case you're unsure about your monitor resolution, then right-click your desktop and select Display Settings. In your Display Settings, scroll down and under Scale and Layout, you'll be able to see your native display resolution. Next, set the Output or Scaled Resolution option to 1920x1080. Below, you will want to set the Downscale filter to Lanczos for the sharpest image, but your PC might lag when streaming, as this will cost you a lot of resources. For low to mid-end PCs, I recommend setting this option to be cubic. Below, set this common FPS values option to 60. Next, open up your favorite browser and navigate to speedtest.net. On this page, you can test your network connection upload and download speed. This is important to know, as you will have to set a bandwidth rate of how much you allow OBS to utilize to stream your content. In case your upload speed is averaging below 4 MB per second, then I suggest setting the FPS option to 30 FPS. While the test is running, navigate to your output settings. Set the output mode to advanced and navigate to the streaming tab. Here, make sure to set the encoder to NVIDIA NVENC in case you're able to utilize a powerful enough NVIDIA graphics card. If this is not the case, then set this option to X264, which will utilize your processor and not your GPU to render your stream. Set the rate control to CBR, which stands for constant bitrate, and below, set the bitrate according to your network connection upload speed. For streams in 1080p and 60 FPS, you should set this to 4500. If you intend to stream in 30 FPS, then a bitrate of 3500 should be more than enough. Below, set the keyframe interval to 2 seconds, preset to quality, profile to main, and the other settings can be left as they are. In the recording section of your output settings, make sure to use MP4 as your recording format. This will not take up a lot of storage and will enable you to edit the video on any video editing software. Again, set the encoder to NVIDIA NVENC, AMD or X264, depending on your graphics card and available resources. I like to use the High Quality Recording preset for my recordings, but in case you are dropping frames while recording, then you should set your recording preset to Recording. This will adjust the settings below. In your Advanced Settings tab, set the Process Priority to above normal. This will reduce lag while recording or streaming when other resource-intensive applications are running in the background. Under Network, bind your IP to your Ethernet connection if you can. This will help OBS optimize the bandwidth usage you have available. Lastly, you should make sure that your graphics card driver is up to date. I suggest using the GeForce Experience application if you're using an NVIDIA GPU, but you can also use the AMD driver suit. In the Drivers tab, simply click on Download and the application will automatically download and install the latest driver, which will take a couple of minutes to complete. For more tips on how to improve your streaming quality and PC performance, make sure to follow my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions and see you in the next one.